Good morning. We've made it to the eighth Sunday after Pentecost, this season being one of the longest in the church years. One thing I would like to announce is, please remember we have flowers every Sunday and a flower sign-up chart in the back. So please, if you have a reason to celebrate or somebody you want to remember, please remember to sign up for flowers so we have beautiful flowers on the altar. Are there any other announcements for today? All right, so we will get started then. Oh, Shirley. So that was a thank you to Nancy for helping with the weeding. Is that what I heard? So thank you, Nancy, for helping with the flower beds. And thank you, Shirley, for all the work that you do out there, too. All right. So please rise. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the God of manna, the God of miracles, the God of mercy. Amen. Drawn to Christ and seeking God's abundance, let us confess our sin. God, our provider, help us. It is hard to believe there is enough to share. We question your ways when they differ from the ways of the world in which we live. We turn to our own understanding rather than trusting in you. We take offense at your teachings and your ways. Turn us again to you. Where else can we turn? Share with us the words of eternal life and feed us for life in the world. Amen. Beloved people of God, in Jesus, the manna from heaven, you are fed and nourished. By Jesus, the worker of miracles, there is always more than enough to share. Through Jesus, the bread of life, you are shown God's mercy. You are forgiven and loved into abundant life. Amen.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, powerful and compassionate, you shepherd your people, faithfully feeding and protecting us. Heal each of us and make us a whole perfect people, that we may embody the justice and peace of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Amen.
Morning. The first lesson comes from Jeremiah. Woe to the shepherds who destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, concerning the shepherds who shepherd my people, it is you who have scattered my flock and have driven them away, and you have not attended to them. So I will attend to you for your evil doing, says the Lord. Then I myself will gather the remnant of my flock out of all the lands where I have driven them, and I will bring them back to their fold, and they shall be fruitful and multiply. I will raise up shepherds over them who have shepherded them, and they shall not fear any longer or be dismayed, nor shall any be missing, says the Lord. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up for David a righteous branch, and he shall reign as king and deal wisely, and shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In his days, Judah will be saved, and Israel will live in safety. And this is the name by which he will be called: the Lord is our righteousness. Here ends the reading. Let us read responsively Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
The Lord makes me lie down in green pastures, and leads me beside still waters.
You restore my soul, O Lord, and guide me along bright pathways for your name's sake.
Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup is running over.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
The second lesson is from Ephesians. Remember that at one time you Gentiles by birth, called the uncircumcision by those who are called the circumcision, a physical circumcision made in the flesh by hands. Remember that you were at that time without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers to the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God in the world. But now in Christ Jesus, you who once were far off have been brought near by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace. In his flesh he has made both groups into one and has broken down the dividing wall, that is, the hostility between us. He has abolished the law with its commandments and ordinances, that he might create in himself one new humanity in place of the two, thus making peace, and might reconcile both groups to God in one body through the cross, thus putting to death that hostility through it. So he came and proclaimed peace to you who were far off and peace to those who were near. For through him both of us have access in one spirit to the Father. So then you are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are citizens with the saints and also members of the household of God, built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the cornerstone. In him the whole structure is joined together and grows into a holy temple in the Lord, in whom you also are built together spiritually into a dwelling place for God. Here ends the reading.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the 6th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. The apostles gathered around Jesus and told him all that they had done and taught. He said to them, "Come away to a deserted place all by yourselves and rest a while." For many were coming and going, and they had no leisure even to eat. And they went away in the boat to a deserted place by themselves. Now many saw them going and recognized them, and they hurried there on foot from all the towns and arrived ahead of them. As he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them, because they were like sheep without a shepherd, and he began to teach them many things. When they had crossed over, they came to a land at Gennesaret and moored the boat. When they got out of the boat, people at once recognized him and rushed about the whole region and began to bring the sick on mats to wherever they heard he was. And wherever he went, into villages or cities or farms, they laid the sick in the marketplace and begged him that they might touch even the fringe of his cloak. And all who touched it were healed. The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Hello out there, all my First Lutheran friends. I'm so sorry that I can't be with you in person today. Because I'm recovering from cataract surgery, I'm really not able to drive just yet. So we've had to make this recording of the sermon. So thank you so much for understanding. I know how eager you are to receive the Lord's Supper, and hopefully I'll recover enough to be able to do that the next time we're together. I was pondering the scripture lessons for this week, and I was taken back to a time in the early days of my ministry. When I was pastoring full-time, I sometimes put in 60 to 65 hours a week, and more if it was a holiday season. I was often exhausted, and I longed for vacation. I couldn't wait for it to come. Often, when I was about ready to leave for a trip, I would get a phone call with a pastoral concern, and I was delayed in getting away. In order to avoid delay, I came up with a plan, and that was to leave 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning to avoid those calls. I needed to rest. I needed God to put me back together again so that I could return to the people renewed and ready to go. And when I did return, the congregation ran for the hills because they knew that I had a bunch of new ideas that needed leaders. I've been thinking about how hard you all have been working through this pandemic and now more than halfway into this new year. So you too must feel exhausted, especially being without a pastor since last September. You've had a lot to learn, a lot of new ways of doing church, of reaching out to people, of caring for the congregation. And you've done an excellent job in keeping the wheels turning and keeping your hearts and your minds open to the promptings of the Holy Spirit. In today's gospel lesson, the disciples had just returned from a mission trip that Jesus sent them on to heal the sick, to cast out demons, to call the people to repentance, and to teach them the way of Jesus. And they traveled light. They took very little, depending on the communities that they encountered, to care for them. When they returned, they had many stories to tell Jesus and each other about their journey and their ministry. They also missed being together, just as we have. After this past year and a half of pandemic, we too have many stories to share with one another about how we made it through, how we kept faith, and how we were able to share the love of God with one another and with those around us, our neighbors and friends, and even strangers. Our ears must be sore from being on the phone so much, and our fingers must ache between texts and emails. Just as Jesus listened to his hardworking disciples, so must we listen to one another as we share this incredible journey that we've been on. Make space to do that sharing time. And then notice what Jesus did next. He said, with deep compassion and love, come away to a deserted place all by yourselves and rest a while. The crowds and the demands were so great that they didn't even have time to eat. Don't you feel like that sometimes? You know, I do. The phone doesn't stop. The emails mount up and I'm exhausted, you know. Jesus knew that we not only need to have compassion for those in need around us, but we need to have compassion for ourselves. We need Sabbath time. It's one of the Ten Commandments, one that we many times ignore. God told us to work 6 days, but to rest on the seventh. I mean, even God did that at the time of creation. But do we? Do we take the necessary break from constant busyness in order to rest? Do we allow God to recreate us, giving God an opportunity to restore us as we rest? I wonder how many of us do that. You know, self-care is very important if we are to have the energy and the creativity to serve the Lord. We need time to reflect, to ponder, to just be. It's one of the ways that we love ourselves. Remember the summary of the law. The first and great commandment is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, all of your soul, and all of your strength. And the second is like it. You are to love your neighbor as yourself. It's not selfish to love yourself. If you don't love yourself, then you really cannot love your neighbor. You won't have it in you to have compassion and love for others if you do not have love and compassion for yourself. This passage from Mark points out to us the way of Jesus, the way of compassion. Mark tells us that Jesus had compassion for the crowds because they were like sheep without a shepherd. Jesus was their shepherd, even as he is our shepherd. He was also the shepherd for his disciples. You know, I have a friend who raises sheep, and I've seen firsthand how the sheep, who are timid and weak and helpless and dependent, how they relate to him as their shepherd. Once I asked him if it was true that the sheep know their shepherd's voice. His sheep were grazing in the field around the house. He opened the window and he called out, "Here's sheep! Here's sheep!" And they all immediately stopped grazing and came running to the window. They knew him. They knew his voice. They knew he would tend them, care for them, protect them, and love them. They trusted him completely. We are the Lord's sheep. Do we trust the Lord the way those sheep trusted my friend? Do we trust that the Lord will care for us, protect us, and love us? Do we trust the truth that we have been taught about Sabbath keeping? Do we rest? Do we rest in the Lord? The last time I preached in June, I was encouraging you all to pick up ministry again, creatively reaching out to one another and to the world around you. When I got done, I realized what you really needed to hear was this sermon. As a church, we are slowly coming back, but we do need to listen to one another, to hear our stories, to ponder what we have learned in the days of isolation. We need to discern what is of utmost importance to us as God's people. This is a time of reorientation, adaptation, and adjustment as we try to get back to whatever the new normal is. Remember, the disciples went out two by two, separated from one another. They probably missed being together as a group of 12 plus Jesus. And Jesus welcomed them back. How happy they were to be together again, just as we all are. They were full of excitement and enthusiasm, glad to see one another again, They shared their stories with one another. And I would imagine that some stories were happy, successful encounters, and some were of a more difficult moment. They were a bundle of emotions. Jesus listened, and after listening, he extended an invitation to them to go to a quiet place, away from all the work, away from all their responsibilities, away from the crowds, and recover. Jesus knew exactly what they needed. To be at rest, to be, is a time that God can recreate us. You know, we use the word recreation to describe being at play, being able to just be, to recreate. Recreation, recreate. Our God will take care of us because we are God's sheep. We will want for nothing. God will lead us beside those still waters and provide nourishment for our souls. God will restore and lead us in the right paths. We've just walked through the dark valley of the pandemic. Hopefully, it's under control, at least in Dutchess County. The Good Shepherd has been with us the whole time, comforting us in many different ways, some of them new to us. It may be that we will have to remember that some people are still hesitant to being back in church in person. Some people are eager. Some people enjoy sipping their coffee in their PJs and relaxing as they tune in on Monday night to watch the recording of the worship service. In this time of reorientation, it helps to remember that God has walked with us the whole time and has blessed us and will continue to bless us as we walk into the future. Trust God and God's wisdom. Take your rest. Let God comfort you and restore you and recreate you as God's people. Remember to keep the Sabbath holy. Work away with all your might for those 6 days, but keep the seventh one to rest in the presence of God. Let God give you the energy and creativity you will be needing in the days ahead. Love yourself as much as God loves you. Then you will be able better to love your neighbor and all of God's great community and creation with that same love. Hear now this blessing that I received this week. Blessed are you who are filled with the fire of compassion, the courage of wisdom, the peace of hope, and the endurance of love. For you will awaken to the Sacred One who is awakening within you. Amen. God bless you all.
Please rise as you are able. We will now profess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Prayers of Intercession. Rooted in Christ and sustained by the Spirit, we offer our prayers for the Church, the world, and all creation. Tend your Church, O God. Encourage bishops, pastors, and deacons in their proclamation of the gospel. Raise up new leaders and encourage those pursuing a call to ministry. Embolden all the baptized to embody your love and justice. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Restore your creation, O God. Sustain croplands and pastures, and safeguard all farm animals and livestock. Preserve lakes, rivers, and streams that offer refreshment. Revive lands recovering from natural disasters, and protect coastlands threatened by rising oceans. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Reconcile the nations, O God. Break down the dividing walls that make us strangers to one another, and unite us as one human family. Equip leaders to deal wisely with conflict and guide diplomats who seek peaceful solutions. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Hear your people, O God. Look with compassion on immigrants, exiles, and all who are afraid or feel lost. Give rest to those who are weary, comfort to those who are grieving, and recovery to those who are ill. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Nourish this congregation, O God. Prepare a table where we receive food for our hungering spirits. Renew our commitment to provide for one another and revitalize our ministries of feeding and nurturing hungry neighbors. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for Linda, Renata, for Judy, and for Ricky's sister, Renata and her friend Charlotte. We pray for Karen's mother, Barbara's mother, Alicia's father, Kurt's mother, for Alice and Ivan and Judy. Be with Sherry in her healing. We also pray for healing for Colleen, Christy, Cowrody, Lita, Roy, Marianne, April, and a speedy recovery for Diane. Our prayers remain with all those among our immediate and extended church, families who serve in medical settings, Nancy, Donna, Erica, Henry, Ryan, and Terry, and Chaplain Kelly Ray at Lutheran Care. We pray for Linda and her cousin Gordon, for Anne's nieces and for her brothers, for Maureen and Frank, Taryn and Chris, and Phil. We pray also for Ricky's other sister and for Scott's sisters, Carol and her brother David, Linda, Jim, Shirley, and Simon, all for healing. We pray for Eddie, Richard and David, and Dale and Dave, each according to their needs. We remember in our prayers today Michael, Tansu, Eunice, Louise, Alice, Mary, and Adele's friend Anne, and for our family and friends in India. We also pray for Teresa as she mourns the death of her sister-in-law. We pray for Colin and his deployment overseas, and for his family as they support him long distance. For all members of our military, together with their families and loved ones, and for the chaplains who administered to them, including Lisa's husband, Anthony. And we pray for our Bishop Paul, assistant to the Bishop Chris, and for our presiding Bishop Elizabeth, for St. John's Lutheran, for St. Paul's Episcopal Church, for the Lutheran Care Center, Dutchess County Interfaith Council, our ecumenical partners, including the World Council of Churches, and for the Church Universal. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
In the ecumenical prayer cycle for today, our sisters and brothers in Djibouti and Somali have asked us to pray for them in praying for protection of natural resources and coastal land, an end to hunger, violence, crime, and conflict in Somalia, effective reconciliation and peace building, stable governments that further the common good for all the people, those who had fled this area that they may be welcomed in new homelands. Lord, in your mercy.
Your mercy is great.
You lead us home, O God. We give thanks for all who have died, now citizens with the saints. As you have received them into the heavenly home, so welcome all of us to dwell in your house forever. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We lift these in all our prayers to you, O God, confident in the promise of your saving love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Glory and praise to you, O God, for your words of promise. With Abraham and Sarah, Moses and Miriam, Deborah and Elijah, Mary and Magdalene, Peter and Paul, we receive your gospel of challenge and comfort. By your Spirit, equip us to serve those in need, faithfully following your word, Jesus Christ, our companion and Savior, now and forever.
Amen.
Now let us say the prayer the Lord taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Hear the blessing. The blessing of God, who provides for us, feeds us, and journeys with us, be upon you now and forever. Amen. Beloved of God, go in peace. You are the body of Christ. Thanks be to God.